What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So I hope you guys all had a great Thanksgiving. It is officially holiday time of the year. And with that, typically comes seasonal depression. So I wanted to talk a little bit on that today. I feel like it's something that isn't always talked about. And I know it's a lot more serious than what we usually get into on this channel, but I just wanted to, discuss it a little bit because it is that time of the year. And I know a lot of you guys go through it. I know I go through it. I mean, it, as you can see, it gets darker outside at like 5 o'clock. It's like pitch black out, which doesn't help because, I feel like that kind of puts people in a funk. And unless you're someone who likes to be freezing cold all the time, like, I feel like being cold can be miserable, you're not getting enough vitamin D, you can't be out as often, and because of that, I feel like it does bring on some depression. Not only that, but some people have issues with holidays, and I've seen a lot of memes and funny things about seasonal depression out now, and I just wanted to take a deeper dive into that and also give some ways to help cope with that. So let's get started. Okay, so one thing I feel like really, really helps is affirmations. Now, affirmations are something that you basically are like, look in the mirror and you tell yourself things to help get your mind in a more positive light. And it feels so funny when you're doing them, but I feel like just doing that can really help bring yourself up to a better level, because I know during this time of the year you can kind of get in a slump, and I feel like bringing that positivity into your life can help. You can find different affirmations online and on Pinterest, and then you can compose a list of like 10, 15 that you want that you feel apply to yourself. But I'm just going to give you an example of some of the ones that I have. So some of the ones that I have are, I have everything I need to be happy and successful. Today is the day I make positive changes. I am always good enough. Everything is possible. I love myself. I trust and believe in myself. I am happy. I am strong and fearless. The list goes on and on. You can find some that you feel like pertain to you specifically, but I don't know. I feel like positive mindset really, really helps. These, like a professional would tell you that you need to do them by staring in one eye, repeat them all, stare in the other eye, repeat them all, and then just stare at yourself and repeat them again. But I know everyone has busy schedules, so if you can't take that much time to do them, just in the morning, look yourself in one eye or just directly in the middle of yourself and just say them one time while you're getting ready. You can do it while you're doing makeup, while you're, I don't know, just doing your hair, whatever. You can say them and start your day with some more positive vibes coming in. So along with this, like, positive mindset, I feel like there's this one thing, I can't remember what video I watched it from, but it was kind of like a TED Talk. I don't know if it was actually a TED Talk. It was a few years back. But what he said to do was basically close your eyes and pretend like they're is this radiating golden orb in your chest. But while you're doing this, you need to picture happiness. You need to feel safe and warm, even if you're trying, even if you're faking it. It doesn't have to be real. Just fake it till you make it. And it even helps if you just like fake a smile or put on a smile while you're doing this. And just imagine this orange globe circling you. Once it circles you, I want you to picture that all around you and feel the warmth and happiness and safety inside of it. Now, in whatever it was that I watched this, he said to continue to spread that around your house and eventually have it spread all the way out till it's around the world. But I find that really hard to do sometimes while I'm trying to keep so much focus. So if you want to start small and then eventually go big, go for it. But once you have this designated space of this warm happiness, you are supposed to basically set intentions. So what you would say is, even if you don't have those things, even if you know you don't have them now, if it's something you want, then that's what you're supposed to say, because you're kind of trying to put this out into the world so that you receive it. So, I only accept positivity in my life. I am happy. I have a steady flow of income. I'm successful. I have a good job. You know, whatever it is that you're wanting in your life right now, even if you don't have that, like, you're supposed to say those. But instead of saying, like, I want a steady income, you're supposed to say, I am grateful and thankful for a steady income. I am grateful and thankful for being happy. I am grateful and thankful for having lots of money. I'm grateful and thankful for being successful. I'm grateful and thankful for whatever it is that you want your life to be, or what you want in your life. You're just supposed to say that like you already have it. And by doing that, it helps motivate you internally and help attract things to you. And I don't know how it works, and honestly, you're gonna feel so weird doing it. It's gonna seem so awkward, but I try to do that whenever I'm going to bed at night. So before I go to bed, I'll be laying there, I'll have my eyes closed, I'll picture the golden orb surrounding me with happiness and warmness, and, you know, whatever. And then I'll say what I'm grateful and thankful for. And while I'm listing off things I'm grateful and thankful for, I'll kind of envision it in a circle. So I'll try to go around and fill the whole circle in my head with things that I'm grateful and thankful for. And I feel like by doing affirmations in the morning and then that at night, you're not only helping to change your mindset to a more positive one, but you're also going to be helping attract this positivity into your life naturally, which is going to help get you out of that mindset, that rut of being incontent. Because I really don't like winters. I don't like anything about winter. I don't want to get out of the house during winter. I don't want to go to school during winter because it's cold and I don't want to leave the house. My motivation leaves me. I just want to, like, hibernate. And I feel like by doing this, you're kind of helping re-get your mind out of that funk, you know? Another thing that you can do is yoga. Now, I know everyone says, do yoga to make you happy. I don't know. I'm not the best at sticking with yoga all the time. But whenever I do yoga, I feel like, I do yoga. I feel like I really like doing the sun salutation, just because I feel like it gives you a flow. It kind of helps ground you, and I feel like it gives you a second to take a break from everything else, get your body moving a little bit, because again, like, it's winter, you can't just go outside and run around. I mean, you could, but would you want to? Probably not. So by doing that, you're getting the blood flowing. And I feel like with the sun salutation, because it kind of moves, every move is kind of like you're flowing through the process. I feel like it's a lot more organic and you have a lot more energy going into it. So I feel like that would be a really good one to do in order to help ground you and, I don't know, help stabilize those feelings of, I don't want to do anything, it's cold, I just want to sit on the couch and wear pajamas all day, you know? So I definitely think that is a good thing to do. Of course, along with yoga, there is, like, drinking water, eating healthy, like, those things really help. I know I struggle with drinking enough water every day, which is something you should totally do because it really does help kickstart your body. And eating healthy, obviously, trying to eat well balanced. At least, even if you do eat fast food, try to balance it out with some veggies later that day just so that you can get some of that nutrients that your body needs to keep you going in there. Another thing that helps with seasonal depression is, like, getting vitamin D. So they do have these lights that basically, like, give you vitamin D, but they're very, very, very expensive. So if you can afford one of those, awesome. They're on Amazon, like, you can totally get those. But if you can't, then if you go to Walmart or Walgreens or wherever you need to go, you can get vitamin D pills. And those can help give you a little bit of that vitamin D that you're lacking because of the fact that we're not in the sun all the time. And the sun's not as potent as it is during summer, so it would help do that. And vitamin D is something that really does affect mood. Like, if you're low on vitamin D, that's not good. It's not good at all. It's not good for your mental health. It's not good for your physical health. So I would totally recommend getting vitamin D pills. The best thing you can do is just try to keep a positive mindset. And everything else will just kind of fall along the way. These are just little coping mechanisms whenever things don't go right. Because sometimes you can try as hard and hard as you want to, but a positive mind, like, is sometimes really hard to achieve. And I know a lot of people out there make it sound like it's just something that's super easy and should just come naturally, but I feel like you really have to work to keep a positive mindset all the time. I read this saying the other day about this challenge to try to avoid all negative thoughts. I think you're supposed to do it for like, try to do it for like 10 days straight or something like that. But every day that you fail, you have to start over at day one. So like, even if you got to day 9 and you had a negative thought, you have to start back over at day one. And your goal is to just keep trying to get to those 10 days. And I haven't tried this one out for myself yet, so I don't know how well it works. And it's probably definitely not an easy thing to accomplish, but it's definitely something that I'm gonna be trying this winter. So hopefully that helps and that works too. If you guys wanna try it as well, then you're welcome to join in and we can see how it goes. Hopefully it is a successful mission, but again, it is so hard to keep negative thoughts out of your mind, especially in this modern day and age. It's just negative thoughts, I don't know, I feel like they're toxic and they cloud your mind. Like, that's so hard. It's like a virus. Like, you can't just turn it off. So I feel like it's definitely gonna be a challenge, but I hope it's a good challenge. And yeah, I hope you guys can do it with me. I know that this holiday season can definitely be hard on people, and it can, I don't know, being cold all the time, just, I don't like winter. I don't like winter at all. If it was my choice, I'd move to some place where winter was like 70 and I'd be happy, but I can't do that. So these are things that I feel like will help. They're definitely something that you have to make yourself do. It's not something that you can just, oh yeah, I'm gonna do that, and then if you put it off, like, it's not gonna help. But if you do it every single day, then it will help. If you do the affirmations in the morning and the intentions at night, and you do the sun salutation like midday or whenever you can fit it in, and you try to drink water with you and eat healthy and take some vitamin D pills, and I guarantee that, I mean, you might not feel as great as you do during summer, but it will help. It will help get you out of that rut, and it'll help keep you motivated and have more energy and more gumption during winter, and help keep your mind out of that seasonal depression, because depression is a really hard thing to deal with, and a lot of people deal with it. And I know I have really bad anxiety, and that can definitely, I don't know, play into the things. And it just really helps if you stay on top of it and be proactive about it, because then even if you don't completely eliminate it, you are doing things to help. And really, it's all about the mental state. I know that depression is an illness, and sometimes you can't treat it with organic, natural things, but I feel like you can try to help curb it and help maintain a healthier state of mind. And I feel like by doing these things, it really helps with that. I really want this to be like an open conversation about seasonal depression. So if you guys have any thoughts or ideas on what you guys think would help seasonal depression, I really want you to comment those down below, so that anyone watching this video needing help for these things can not only see what I feel like would help, but also what you guys think would help. Because I know different things can help different people. I just wanted to bring some light to it, because I don't know, I know depression and anxiety are a huge thing, and I just want it to be an open discussion and to help people, because I know sometimes people need help. So I know this was a different sort of video than normal, but I just really wanted to talk about it since it's that time of the year, and I don't know, I feel like it's something that should be talked about, so I hope if you are someone that is needing help with this, that these things do help you, and if not, you can give your feedback down below. Like, I'm just really happy even if I can help one person. Even if it just makes one person get through the winter a little bit better, that means the world to me. So, if you guys liked this video, give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and we will see you next week with something a little bit more upbeat. So just hang in there, winter will be over before we know it, and try to enjoy the holidays. See you guys later, bye!